What's good, folks? It's Nightmare Frame here with a new Warframe video, coming at you with a beast of an Atlas build, using a helmet ability. Usually people would think to put Larva or Ensnare on Atlas, or even Roar, or even Defy, for some weird reason. But let's be real, if you want crazy scaling damage, just put Breed Surge Forehead, and this is what we got.
Did it? What type of damage and what percent does that new core have?
Millions of damage, and even one-shotting an Acolyte. Nice sense of balance, a true power fantasy. The power of Breed Surge is out of this world. First, let's break down on how Breed Surge works. You pretty much send out sparks of energy that expand and latch onto enemies' faces. These sparks only affect enemies within line of sight, and enemies struck with this ability will be stunned and blinded, and damaging the afflicted enemies will spread this affliction to nearby enemies, and those enemies affected by Breed Surge will take multiplicative damage, and the blinded enemies are susceptible to stealth multiplier damage, so the scaling potential is high. Breed Surge has a better synergy with certain damage types that help re-trigger the surge sparks on enemies' heads, and those are gas, electric, heat, and toxic, pretty much any AoE damage, which Landslide does, in a way, since it has a small explosion radius. So you will get surge sparks that lash out to nearby enemies, dealing radiation damage corresponding to the amount of damage you've dealt on the affected enemies. Those surge sparks will send multiplied damage as radiation damage, hitting other enemies, and those enemies will end up re-triggering more sparks. So it's a vicious circle of damage. The damage multiplier and status chance both scale from power strength. I did release an Atlas vid a while back, but that was without crits. Okay, so Atlas's main damaging ability is his Landslide, his first ability. It is a melee pseudo-exalted weapon. So similar to Korra's Whipclaw, Gaara's Shattered Lash, and Slash Dash from Excalibur. That means it has its own stats and will scale off power strength, melee equipped mods, and combo counter. The ability itself mainly deals impact damage and has 5% crit chance and status chance. Remember, damage type and the status effects are two different things. Now that you know what it is, this means you need a stat stick. Alright, listen up. A stat stick is a melee weapon not used as a traditional melee weapon, but as a vessel that uses mods to boost your Warframe's ability, meaning the melee weapon does not matter, nor the weapon stats, just the mods. I repeat, the weapon does not matter, just the mods. The ability already has its own stats, and putting mods on a melee weapon will help boost the stats of the ability. You're not modding the melee, but the ability, since the ability scales from the mods on a melee weapon, so any melee weapon can be used as a stat stick, as the weapon itself doesn't matter, only the mods. Trust me, I have to repeat this. And the only time when a specific melee would matter is when you're going for a melee with a high Riven disposition. Other than that, anything works. All you have to do is take a melee and put mods in. That's how pseudo-exalted weapons work, and will work until DE changes that. In terms of Rivens, negative faction, range, attack speed, status duration, and status chance, slash, puncture do not affect the damage output of the Landslide, but are actually welcomed. Avoid having bonus status chance because you're just dealing raw damage. Usually, I would not mod his Landslide for crits, but I wanted to have some fun. So, if you're going for a crit build, you want crit chance, crit damage, and damage with a negative on a Riven. For a non-crit build, you want damage, an element, impact, and a negative. Why negative? Because having a negative will greatly increase the positive values of your Riven, depending on the disposition. If you want to know more about Rivens, do check out my Riven guide. Alright, let's take a look at the build. Brief respite in the aura for the energy usage to shield conversion. So depending on how much energy you use, you get shields instead. This helps you regain your shields for another instance of a shield gate. Enemy sense in the Exilus for the consistent enemy markers, and no need for vigilante because I am not using primaries. A rank 4 fleeting expertise for the 50% added efficiency. It also reduces duration, so you counteract that with primed continuity. Power strength at 155% with the use of the 2 umbral mods. This helps increase damage output on his landslide, rumblers, and the damage multiplier on breach surge. Stretch for the coverage on breach surge and the reach and explosion on Atlas's other abilities. Natural talent for the increase in casting speed, which makes him fluid and fast. Rubble heap will increase my damage output and travel speed on landslide when you have over 1400 rubble. Adaptation for the 90% damage resistance towards status effects. This is an absolute survivability as it doesn't make you unkillable. 10% of a huge damage number will still kill you. Arcane Avenger for the increase in crit chance when you take damage. Alright, let's take a look at the Statstick build. Remember what I said earlier about Statsticks. If you didn't listen or pay attention, then it's on you. Alright, this is a non-Riven build. As you can see, raw damage, two forms of crits with Blood Rush and Sacrificial Steel, modded for Corrosive because it's the best raw damage element and works well for a lot of enemy units. Crit multiplier and impact mod since Landslide's main damage type is impact. No need for attack speed, range, or any of that since it does not affect Landslide at all. And for my focus school, I'm running Neuromod to maintain my combo counter so I deal more damage on Landslide. For added damage multipliers, I will be using Kuva Nucor and Helios. It's not for condition overload because that doesn't work with Atlas, but for the 10 stacks of viral and some heat procs, easy. And the Helios uses Detect Vulnerability. This will work like a pocket sonar banshee, highlighting weak spots on enemies you have fully scanned, giving you a 275% damage multiplier against them. As you see, using different types of damage multipliers will give you big numbers. Unfortunately, you can't red crit with Atlas, but this still one-shots pretty much everything along with Acolytes. Anyway, folks, this is the big PP damage on Atlas. That has been it for me. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, feel free to leave a like, share, and subscribe for more Warframe content, streams, and so much more. Do refer to the description. Thanks for watching, and as always, peace.